Hello everyone, I'm Lilian Pintea, Vice President of Conservation Science for the Jane Goodall Institute, USA. How do you connect planting trees with stopping deforestation and assuring healthy forests and habitats for animals, people, and the environment? The linkages are more complex than you might think, and it takes commitment and partnerships from local communities to scientists and policymakers to get it right and achieve positive change. In 1994, our local teams and colleagues in Tanzania went to the villages around Gombe National Park in the larger Greater Gombe ecosystem and engaged in a process of active listening, planning, and action that now we call TAKARE, our community-driven approach to conservation. One of the first initiatives, often requested and supported by the TAKARE project, was planting trees to address the rapid increase in deforestation on the village land outside Gombe National Park. By 2004, TAKARE tree planting efforts spread to 14 villages outside Gombe. However, something was just not right. Despite TAKARE efforts, the deforestation rate in areas important to chimpanzees has still doubled. That's why in 2005, we partnered with the Nature Conservancy to adopt in our work in Tanzania a systematic conservation action planning approach, widely used by the Conservancy in North America and other regions, and to help connect community livelihood efforts with conservation objectives. Building on TAKARE's success and partnership with the local communities, conservation action planning process enabled scientists, local government officials, and other stakeholders to have a dialogue and collaborate, all informed by science and local knowledge and expertise. After all the planning work was done, we had some insights. You see, tree planting was intended to provide local people as an alternative source of timber for boat construction and household consumption. However, the planning process and the satellite imagery and mapping revealed that the main threat to forest outside Gombe was actually farming. Most of the forests and woodlands were converted to agricultural use, while tree planting and nurseries were still important to support people's livelihoods and need for timber, additional strategies were needed to address deforestation. Equipped with this new knowledge and guided by a spatial conservation plan, the Jane Goodall Institute Tanzania team adapted. It started to facilitate land use planning with village and district governments, and to build local capacity, such as the use of smartphones by village forest monitors to enforce the village land forest reserves. And only then we started to see some positive change happening in the landscape. Like these woodlands, naturally regenerating between 2005 and 2014, as seen from Maxar satellite images. Today, the conservation planning approach evolved into an open standards for the practice of conservation, and it is an important tool as part of our TAKARE toolbox, helping to connect the needs of local communities with ecosystem services and to support nature-based development. It is also at the core of our Africa programs and the Jane Goodall Institute strategy, creating meaningful partnerships all across the chimpanzee range and creating windows of opportunities to influence real on-the-ground conservation decisions. From Tanzania to Eastern DRC, western part of the Republic of Congo, and now to the entire chimpanzee range in West Africa. We're doing this work with partners like ARCOS, ICN Section on Great Apes, the Nature Conservancy, ESRI, and many, many others. And we're reaching to many other organizations through networks like Conservation Measures Partnership. This opens new possibilities, how we could work together, how we could collaborate to scale our joint impact, and how we can transform a powerful but personal action like planting a tree into a healthy forest for animals, people, and the environment. I want to thank you all, our partners, and you for your support, and welcome to join us to make it happen. Thank you.